Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. In this example, we're looking at using a normal distribution to approximate probability for a binomial distribution. During a genetic study, researchers believed that 23% of the population they were studying would have a genetic marker for a certain disease. Of the 600 subjects in the study, 120 of them had the genetic marker the researchers were looking for. Assuming that the researcher's rate of 23% is correct, find the probability of getting 120 or fewer people with a genetic marker by chance. That is, if n is 600 and p equals 0.23, find the probability of having at most 120 with a genetic marker. And is the 120 people with a GM significantly low? Is that a significantly low number? Assuming that the 23% assumption is correct in a study with 600 subjects. Well, before you do that, you have to make sure that we meet the requirement that n times p, n is the number of people in the sub, is your number 600, times the probability, and p is the probability of success, which is in this case 0.23, which doesn't sound like success if you have a bad genetic marker, but that's how we're counting it. And then the 600 times Q, which is the probability of failure, which would mean they don't have it. And both of those have to be greater than or equal to 5. That should be equal to there. Okay, so the probability is 0.23, P. So Q is 1 minus 0.23, or 0.77. So we take 600 times 0.23 and get 138. And 600 times 0.77 and get 462. So the requirement is satisfied. So we can use a normal distribution for this. For our mu, or our mean, we're going to take the NP. So we're going to take 600, which is our N, times the probability, and that gave us that 138. So our mean is 138. The standard deviation in these kind of problems is the square root of NPQ. Our N was 600, our P is 23, or 0.23, and the Q is 0.77. Multiply those together and take the square root to get an approximation of 10.3082. I say this all the time, but it's worth mentioning again. Always round to the number that you're asked to round to. So you might be asked to round to 3 places or 2 by your instructor, but for me, I'm rounding standard deviation out to 4 places here. Okay, after we find the mu and the sigma, we're going to find the use the continuity correction on x. That means, because when we have a binomial distribution, those are discrete values, like countable numbers, like 120. But normal distribution is continuous. And so to fix that little error, we subtract or add 0.5 onto our x. X is the number of successes specifically we're looking at. So to correct that, we're going to take 120 minus 0.5, which will be 119.5, or 120 plus 0.5, which is 120.5. Since we're looking at most, so we're looking to everything to the left, we use the value that's the greatest. We always want to go the furthest away from what we're looking at. So we're looking at negative infinity. The furthest away here would be 120.5. If we were saying at least, then we would use the 119.5 and look to the right. Okay, so we know our value that we're going to look at is 120.5. We're going to use technology to find the probability of this particular event occurring. And I have videos posted on how to use StatCrunch or the TI-36X Pro to do this. This is a screenshot from StatCrunch. So the mean that we found was 138, that goes here, and the standard deviation was 10.3082, so that went here. I was looking for everything to the left of that, so I'm going to look at less than equal to, and I was looking at 120.5, and when I put that in, I get 0.04478432. So now that I have that, I have to then understand my results. This is saying the probability that we could, by chance, have 120 subjects with the genetic marker that we're looking for, assuming that the 23% was correct, is 0.0448. And that is about 4.5%, right, which is less than the 5% cutoff. Therefore, We can say that 120 is a significantly low number. We would not expect to get that by chance. It's very rare that that would happen. So when you're looking at this, you say, well, is this something that could happen by chance? Not usually. Not to say it never could happen, but it would be very rare. And so what that tends to do is contradict the researcher's assumption that it should happen 23% of the time. Maybe that assumption was incorrect to begin with. Okay, that's that one. And if in that same problem where we had a mean of 138 and a standard deviation of this, if they had asked, what's the probability that exactly 143 people had the genetic marker? So when we're talking about exactly, we use that continuity correction to find the value on the left and right. So to the left of 143 would be 142.5. And to the right of that would be 142 and 143.5, excuse me, whatever I said, I don't remember. And so we're looking at this little range. You want to put that 143 in the middle of that range. So we go down by 0.5 and up by 0.5. And that shows us 0.0343 or 44 if I round to four places. And so the probability estimate is 0.0344, which is less than 5%. So this is a significantly high number of people with a genetic marker. So if we have a value here that's more than 5%, then we say that falls within the range of an expected value. But this is sort of outside that range. That's a high, significantly high number, whereas the other one was significantly low number. All right, have a fantastic day.